Good evening, and welcome everyone to Annie the Musical. We all grew up watching musicals, and when I was asked by my favorite boss, Mrs. Shada Abi Khalil, to work on the major production for the 150th anniversary of BHS, the first musical that came to my mind was Annie. The casting was as easy as a pie, for I know our students, their capabilities. But you wouldn't be here tonight watching our stars shining on stage if it wasn't for the support of many people who stood by us. Mr. Gray, our principal, who was always supportive, Mr. Raymond Frali, Mr. Anis Saad, Mr. Tony Dawood, Mr. Camille Khalil, Music Factory, Mark Hatem and his team, where we recorded all the songs and the music, Mrs. Rula Deeb, and Mrs. Sabine Abu Jaudeh, who was not just a costume designer at all. Last but not least, I want to thank the students who will be performing tonight for their commitment, devotion, and passion for theater, because without you and only you, we wouldn't be here tonight. I really hope you enjoy the show.
Anybody get any sleep around here?
Mama! Mommy!
I said shut your trap, Molly!
Stop shoving the poor kid, she ain't doing nothing to you!
She keeping me awake, ain't she?
No, you're keeping us awake!
You wanna make something out of it?
How about to make a pancake out to you?
Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness, they're fighting! And I won't get no sleep all night! Oh my goodness!
Pipe down, all of you, go back to sleep!
It's alright, Molly, Annie's here.
It was my mom, Annie. We was riding on the ferry boat and she was holding me up to see all the big ships. And then I couldn't find her no more.
No, it was only a dream. Now, honey, you gotta go back to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, can you read me your note?
Again?
Please?
Sure, Molly.
Here it comes again.
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We will be back to get her soon.
We have left half a golden locket around her neck and kept the other half so that when we come back for her, you will know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Now they're laughing.
All right. Do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I dream about having a mother and father, but you're lucky. You really got them.
I know. Somewhere.
Maybe far away, or maybe real nearby. He may be pouring her coffee. She may be straining his tie. Maybe
Addy, what are you doing?
Running away.
Oh my goodness!
My folks are never coming back for me. I gotta go find them.
Annie, you're crazy. Sanagan will catch you.
And give you the paddle.
I don't care. Alright, I'm ready. Wish me luck.
Good luck, Annie!
So long, Dustin. And good luck. Got you!
Get up!
Turn around. There. Now, what do you say? What do you say?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Rotten orphan?
I'm not an orphan. My mom and dad left notes saying they loved me and they were coming back for me.
That was 11 years ago. Now, for this one's shenanigans, you'll all go down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump until it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Get to work.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
She's so annoying. I need a broom.
She's so annoying. I hate it.
There's no broom.
What do you think? Hate.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us.
Instead of tooted,
we get tricked.
Instead of kisses,
we get kicked. It's a hard knock life. Got no folks to speak of, so it's a hard knock road we hoe.
Got no blankets,
set of wool.
Empty bellies,
set of wool. It's a hard knock life.
Don't it feel like the wind is always howling? Don't it seem like there's never any night? Once a day, don't you run over the tiling?
It's easier than putting up advice.
No one's there when your dreams are not get creepy. No one cares if you grow or if you shrink. No one tries when your ears get wet and weepy.
From the crying, you would think this place would sing.
Santa Claus we never see.
Santa Claus, what's that? Who's he? No one cares for you a smidge when you're in an orphanage. It's a hard knock life.
You stay up till this dump shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
You're good with your summer chin. Jabber with a safety pin. Make her drink a Mickey fin. I love you, Miss Hannigan.
Get to work. Strip them bed. I said, get to work.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life for us. No one cares for you when you're in an orphanage. It's a hard knock life.
Thank you.
Good morning, children.
Good morning, Miss Hannigan.
Well?
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
I love you, Miss Hannigan.
What are you doing up there?
Nothing.
Get her down here. Your days are numbered. Breakfast.
Hot mush! Yuck!
No, not hot mush. Cold mush. And after your mush, you'll get to your sewing machines. There's an order of justice to be finished, even if you have to work straight through midnight. Line up.
Laundry! Laundry man!
Morning, bundles!
Morning, kids! Clean sheets once a month, whether you need them or not. Hey! hey, Aggie! How's the prettiest girl south of 14th Street?
Bundles, do me a favor, get out of here!
So long, gorgeous, and have a good day.
Annie, you call this place clean? This place is like a pixie.
Annie ain't here.
What do you mean, Annie ain't here?
She just went with Mr. Bundles
in his truck.
Bundles!
Amanda.
Lucky dog, she got away, but we're gonna have to pay. Gonna get our faces slapped, gonna get our knuckles wrapped. It's a hard knock life, it's a hard knock life. It's the hard knock life.
Apples, 2 for a nickel.
Excuse me, sir, but could you donate an apple to the orphans' picnic?
Why not? Nobody's buying them anyway.
Gee, thanks, mister.
Say, kid, when is the orphans' picnic?
Soon as I take a bite.
Hey, you, little girl. Come here. You seen any shameouts around here?
No, officer.
Good. Then they must all be running wild over to Astor Place.
There's one they didn't get. They're after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me, too. But I promise I ain't gonna let them get you or me. If not today, well, maybe sometime.
The sun will come out tomorrow, but your bottoms all of that tomorrow. There'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stuck on my chin and grin and sing. The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow.
Girl, come here.
Yes, officer.
That dog there, ain't he a stray?
It's
Trey, oh no, officer, he's my dog.
Your dog, huh? What a cute dog you have. So, what's his name?
Sandy. I call him Sandy because of his nice sandy color.
Okay, let's see him answer to his name.
Well, you see, officer, I just got him a week ago and sometimes he doesn't...
Call him!
Here's Sandy, boy, here's Sandy. Good Sandy, good old Sandy.
Next time you take him out, I want to see him on a leash and with a license, or else he goes to the pound.
I understand, officer.
Now, get along with yourself before you catch your death of freezing cold in this weather.
Miss Hannigan, remember your souvenir pillow from Coney Island? Molly just threw up on it.
Little girls, everywhere I turn, I can see them. Little girls, night and day, I eat, sleep, and breathe them. Some women are dripping with diamonds. Some women are dripping with pearls. Lucky me, look at what I'm dripping with, little girls. Someday I'll step on their freckles. Some night I'll straighten their curls. Send a flu. Anything that you can do to little girls.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yeah.
I'm Lieutenant Ward from the 17th Precinct. We found your runaway.
Well, thank you, officer.
She was near the Hoovervilles, over to the river. With a bunch of bums.
They weren't bums.
Had the mangy mutt with her, but he got away.
Oh, poor pumpkin. Out in the freezing cold with just that thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza.
I hope you didn't catch influenza.
Thank you so much again, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, don't let me ever hear you run away from this nice lady again. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. The next time you walk out that door, it'll be over my dead body. So, are you glad to be back?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you to do? Never tell a lie.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Good afternoon.
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? The millionaire?
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the next 2 weeks at his home.
What sort of orphan does he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital MISSISSIPPI, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
Shut up! And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Let's say 8 or 9. 10, 11. Yes, 11 would be perfect. Oh, and I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers short hair.
11. Short hair. I'm sorry, we don't have any orphans like that.
What about this child right there?
Annie? You don't want Annie.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' house?
I would love to. You can have any orphan here, but not Annie.
Perhaps I should call the Board of Orphans and maybe...
It's Annie wants Annie you get.
It's Annie I want.
Oh boy.
If you'll get her a coat, I'll take her along right now.
She don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one.
Oh boy.
Come along, Annie. Mr. Warbuck's limousine is outside.
Oh boy, I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it?
Hey kids, I'm getting out for a while. I'm right to you.
Y'all come here for a moment.
This is everyone. Hi, everyone.
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear. Now, what would you like to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them first. And then I'll get to the windows next.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning around here. You're our guest. And for the next 2 weeks, you're going to have a swell time.
Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Green is her best color. No, blue, I think.
Your bath is drawn by Mrs. Greer. Annette comes in to make your bed. I think I'm gonna like it here.
Where is everybody? Oh, hello everybody.
Sir?
Sir.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad, only took 11 hours. Grace?
Yes, sir?
Any messages?
The governor wants you to call him.
I'll get back to him tomorrow. All right, good to see you all again.
Sir?
Sir.
But wait, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake, dismiss the staff.
Yes, sir.
And Grace? if you'll get your notebook. Who is that?
This is Zanny, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan who will be with us for the next 2 weeks.
That's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Well, I suppose she'll have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
It's just Annie, Mr. Warbucks, sir. I haven't gotten any last name. Oh, and I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Not at all. I couldn't be happier. Grace, we'll start with the iron ore shipments from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
Well, it is her first night here, sir.
Well, Annie, I guess we ought to do something special on your first night. Would you like to go to the movies?
Gosh, Mr. Warbucks, I've never been to one.
Then you'll go to the Roxy and get an ice cream soda at Rumpelmayer's and a handsome cab ride around Central Park.
Jolly!
Grace, forget about the dictation tonight. Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Oh, gee.
What is it, Annie?
It's just that, well, I thought you'd take me there.
Well, I'm afraid I'll be far too busy tonight.
Oh, gee.
See, Annie, I've just been away for 6 weeks, and when a man is running a multi-billion dollar corporation...
Oh, I know, that's okay, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake, get our coats.
Oh, gee.
What car will you be wanting, sir?
The Duesenberg. No, wait. This child's been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
Wait, what? Walk to the Roxy?
Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove that just because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over.
I hope not. Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? Warbucks fed up with Annie already?
On the contrary, Miss Hannigan, this has to be signed and sent back to the Board of Orphans no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow.
What for?
Well, Mr. Warbucks is so taken with Annie that he wants to adopt her.
Annie, the daughter of a millionaire.
The daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for just a moment, please? Got any more wonderful news?
Have a nice day, Miss Hannigan.
Oops, pardon me, beauty. Hiya, sis. Long time no see. Rooster, they finally let you out of that prison? What were you in for this time?
Some old geezer said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Why'd you say that?
Because the rooster swindled him out of $1,100.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a new friend of mine from
Jersey City.
Rooster, do me a favor. Get out of here.
So who was this beauty I bumped into when I come in? Looked like she had a couple of dollars.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks?
One of the orphans here is getting adopted by him.
Crummy orphan.
Yeah, living in the lap of luxury while the two Hannigan kids ended up on the skids.
It ain't fair how he drowns for $3 or $4 while she gets Warbucks.
The little brat. Ain't it fair? This here life is driving me nuts. Well, we get peanuts. She's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less.
Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Give you one.
Yes! Easy Street! Easy Street! Annie is the key. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
morning, sir.
Good. I'm gonna give it to you.
And then tell her I wanna adopt her.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. So I made the promise to myself that someday, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
But I've lately realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you're alone and you have no one to share it with, then you might as well be broke. I was at Tiffany's yesterday, and I brought this for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Oh, gee.
It's a golden locket, Annie. I noticed that old broken one you always wear, and I wanted to get you a much better one. Here, we'll just take this old
one. No, I don't want a new one.
What is it, Annie?
This locket. My mother and father left it when they left me at the orphanage. And a note, too. They're coming back for me. I know I'm really lucky being here with you for the next 2 weeks, but the one thing I always wanted in the whole world is to be like other kids with folks of my own.
It'll be all right, Annie. I'll find them. I'll find your parents for you.
Don't worry, Annie. Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father. If he has to put everyone in his organization to the job, if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Annie, give me your locket.
But, Mr. Warbucks...
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We'll have the police trace it and find out who bought it.
Then they should have my note, too.
You watch, Annie. You may be meeting your mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
Oh, boy, I gotta write a letter to the kids about this.
And welcome to Brumana's favorite radio station, the Occident Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. Good evening, Oliver Warbucks. It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening, Bert. Healy, it's nice to be here.
Oliver Warbucks, I hear you have something to tell the folks at home about little Annie here.
Yes, I'm now conducting a coast-to-coast, nationwide search for Annie's parents. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents.
Wow!
So Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care to this station. Thank you, Oliver.
Thank you, Bert, Healy.
Well, I see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers has gone by faster than you can say Occident. So this is your old softie, Mrs. Healy's boy, Bert, saying, until next week, same time, same station, good night.
Wow, Annie on the radio, coast to coast, she's really famous.
Now, I also really wish I was on the radio too.
Me too.
Who wants to be on a Donald radio anyway?
I do. So, for all the hours of smiles, this is Bert Healy saying...
Hey, Hobo Man, hey, Dapper Dan, you've both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be bold Romany, they stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Who cares what they're wearing on Main Street or Seven? It's what you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe, that matters. So senator, so janitor, so long for a while, remember you're never fully dressed. Though you may wear a vest, you're never fully dressed without a
doing up.
Annie was on the radio.
Yeah, I heard it. Next thing should be in the movies. Now get, now go shower.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
A $50,000 reward. $50,000.
Yeah.
What couldn't I do? $50,000.
Yes, ma'am. Are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah.
Mom, was you working it up here 11 years ago?
Yeah.
Well, we had terrible troubles back then and had to leave a baby here on the front stoop.
Oh, no, take care of our Annie.
Your Annie's parents? I can't believe it. Where do you say you come from again?
A little farm up in Canada where they've got lots of chickens and ducks and geese and roosters. R-R-R. Gotcha, sis.
Rooster, I would have never known it was you in 100 years.
Ha, fooled you, Aggie, and we're gonna fool Warbucks too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
We need your help, sis, for details about Annie.
What?
That can help us pull this thing off.
What's in it for me?
Three-way split.
Half.
Half?
Half.
Okay, 25 grand each, but we gotta do it fast. Get the money, get the kid, and get out of town.
The kid's the problem. What are we gonna do with her afterwards?
No problem. When I want something to disappear, it disappears for good. Now, we get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy town, and then Lil and me will meet you.
Where? Oh.
Well, Miss Pearl?
I'm sorry, Annie. I've spoken to more than 1,000 people claiming to be your parents. But they were all just liars and fakes.
Oh, gee.
Are you certain?
Yes, Mr. Warbucks. None of them knew about the locket.
I was sure somebody was going to be my mother and father.
Mr. Warbucks, this had to come by a special messenger.
Oh, finally. Agent Gunderson located the manufacturer of Annie's locket in Utica, New York.
Oh boy!
Over 90,000 were made and sold?
Oh gee.
Annie, I'm afraid the police doesn't think that there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents to the locket.
That's okay. I guess a kid could get along without folks of their own. You didn't turn out so bad.
Grace?
Yes, sir?
Do you have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Right here.
Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my mother and father, there's no one in the world I'd rather to have as a father than you, Mr. Warbucks. I'm the luckiest man. I'm the luckiest kid.
And I'm the luckiest man.
Yeah, up.
Together at last, together forever. We're tying a knot they never can sever. I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. Yesterday was plain awful. You can't say that again. Yesterday was plain awful. But that's not now, that's then. I'm poor as a mouse. I'm richer than Midas. But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple seller too, I don't need anything, anything, anything. I don't need anything but you.
Shirley, look, there's our Annie.
Who are you?
Annie, we're your mom and dad.
Mudge is the name, Ralph Mudge. And this here is the wife, Shirley.
And you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
But we've seen a great number of people who...
I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Here's our driver's license and Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl named Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th.
October 28th, that's my birthday.
Ralph, look, Annie's wearing the locket.
When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half a golden locket with her and kept the other half. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph, she's our Annie.
Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'd be glad to give whatever.
You haven't heard that I've offered a certified check of $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they're Annie's parents?
No, sir. Anyways, we don't want no money.
On the other hand, Ralph and our little pig farm in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could afford to bring Annie up right to the country.
Mr. Mudge, would you mind if Annie stayed here until tomorrow morning? Then you can pick her up and the check.
Whatever you prefer, sir.
Bye, Annie, love.
Until tomorrow morning, honey. And then you'll be spending the rest of your lives with us.
Oops, pardon me, beauty.
Well, this is...
wonderful news.
Drake, we must celebrate.
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate because Annie has found her mother and father.
Wait, Annie!
I've lost her. I've lost Annie.
Sir, I have the strangest feeling that these people are not who they say they are.
Then I won't give her up till we're certain.
But how?
I'll go straight to the top, to the governor. You're up early.
You're up early.
Annie, we've been up all night, dear. Policemen coming and going. And did you know that the governor is here?
Really?
Governor?
Hi.
Very sad news. They have succeeded in tracking the identity of your parents.
Yes, Shirley and Ralph Mudge.
No, dear. David and Margaret Bennett.
Annie, your mother and father passed away a long time ago.
So you're saying I'm an orphan after all.
Are you all right, Annie?
Yes, because I knew they loved me. And they would have come back for me if they weren't... Well,
I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you too. Now who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could easily have been forged. No one knew about the locket, except us.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan too, and the kids from the orphanage.
Hi, kids!
Annie! Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet
Same
you.
Same here, I'd know you anywhere.
Miss Hannigan, I would like to introduce you to everyone. This is my butler, Jake. And this is the governor. And this is my secretary, Miss Farrell.
Look, kids, there's presents there for all of us.
Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning!
Good morning, man and all!
Good morning.
Well, we don't mean to interrupt the party and all, but we've just come to pick up the check. And Annie!
Ah yes, of course, the check. $50,000 certified.
Certified, paid to the order of. The jig is up!
Yes, the jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Lewis, turn them over.
And I believe that you'll find that this woman is their accomplice.
Me? I've never seen these people till yesterday.
Ah, come off it, Aggie.
Annie? Tell them how good and nice I've always been to you.
I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but what the one thing you always taught me? Never tell a lie.
That!
That went up.
Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
And you won't have to work anymore.
Yes, you. For you and perhaps for all of us here, this evening is going to be a new beginning to a wonderful new life. A new deal, yes, I rather like that. A new deal.
Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just suck on my chin and grin and say, the sun will come out tomorrow. We're gonna hang on till tomorrow.
I love you.
I love you.
Tomorrow, you're always
the sun come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't know if this is working or not, but I would like to thank May and her sister Rula for directing this wonderful production. I thought the children were marvellous. Their acting was tremendous, the choreography was lovely, and the singing, whether it was live or recorded, was first class. And what really impressed me was that they faced quite a number of obstacles in the show tonight. Things like the props falling down, the sound failing, but it's to their credit that they didn't give up. And what they produced in the end was something that was rather splendid and memorable, I think, for all of us. So I'd like to thank the boys and girls. They're just primary 6 and 7 children for their marvellous performance and for keeping going right till the end. And it kind of emphasises something that Jad Khalil said last night at the grade 6 graduation, which is never give up. And they didn't. They went right to the end and the finale was wonderful. And I'm sure that they'll be looking forward to repeat the performance tomorrow evening. So thank you very much indeed. And thank you for coming in such large numbers. I hope you enjoyed the show.